This chart, if you come inside the Bloomberg, is what kind of anyone was talking about in the last 3 months, and that's that big rise that we saw in LIBOR. How do you understand the shift that we're seeing, and will this rise stop hurting?
Well, two questions. SOFR isn't doing anything to this. This is the underlying demand pull of what's going on for the increase in rates, but that's reflecting underlying real economic forces. The SOFR, I think, is actually something that we should all be pleased about, Alix, because while this looks to be working okay right now, that is LIBOR, 2008 showed this was a sham mechanism. Luckily, most of the time it worked. It was a bunch of guys, no women, guys sitting in a room in London and putting together their heads, sometimes 10, sometimes 20, saying, I think today we should, they were asked their opinions and then they came up with a number. That's not a way to do business.
Good thing they worked. Got paid more, right?
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
Yeah, unfortunately, some went to jail. But
yeah, now you have a situation where this is going to be based on market phenomenon, market prices. This is a good thing. It's going to take, as Michael was saying earlier, it's going to take a while for this thing to actually transplant, but it's a move in the right direction.
Whether LIBOR was a sham or not, and I think that you're absolutely right, that's why we're moving away from it, because
right.
It wasn't based on the real marketplace.
Right.
A lot of transactions were tied to LIBOR. A lot of borrowing was tied to it. I mean, we have a bar chart. I think it's like
all of our lives, David, are suffused. People don't understand. This is actually a big deal for everyday Americans.
Well, my question is, if you have this $370 trillion linked to something, is it important that we have one thing like LIBOR that replaces it, or can we have multiple? Because right now there are going to be various horses in this race. SOFR is just one of the possibilities.
As a businessman, you know you have traditions and things that work. And the having a single thing has made it easier to do transactions when you're pricing things. But I think in the future we're going to have multiple. That's probably a little more confusing for business people to do it that way. But I think it's a better transaction.
Also joining us on the phone is Ira Jersey of Bloomberg Intelligence, who follows everything labeled fixed income. Ira, what do you feel like the short-term repercussions of this are going to be as loans have to now take into effect SOFR versus LIBOR?
Yeah, I think very short term it's going to take a little while for SOFR to gain traction. We're going to have the first instruments that are going to trade off it that'll start trading in about a month, which will be futures on the SOFR. After that's when take up can potentially happen. I think at first you might need someone like some banks, for example, maybe to issue some bonds based on SOFR. Mm-hmm. A couple of banks maybe to start trading over the counter derivatives, and this process will take several years, but I do think that assuming that there's take-up and that the market believes that LIBOR is going away in 2021, then people aren't going to have much of a choice, actually. They will have to choose a different reference rate other than LIBOR.